discipline, perseverance, fight. These are the characteristics you've cultivated, the qualities you applied time and time again. In practice, in competition, after class, before sunrise, on the weekend. Your peers relaxed, slept in. They went to brunch in the middle of the day, but you worked, you grinded, you won, you lost, and hit it that much harder the next day. See, that's what it takes to be a Heron. You push and you pull and you fight for your 5 minutes of glory. When the contest is over and the victory is won, and for a moment, you are a champion. And to the school you represent, the community you come from, the little girls who want to be you, the little kid you once were, who dreamed and prepared for this moment, to them, you are a hero. Then again, maybe you never got there. Maybe you don't have the ring, never hoisted the trophy or donned the medal. Oh, you had focus and determination. You played to the last whistle, never looked back. You left everything on the court, executing at the full potential of your strength and skill. And still, the best you could say is you held your head high and met defeat with poise. Is there not heroism in that too? No honor in that effort, no value in that lesson? I'll tell you something right now. You may have lived for the wins, and of course you did. What's the point of striving if not for a compelling goal? Your Herons, of course you wanted the W. But you were made in the toil and the grind, in the second shots and the waiting, in the pain, and yes, even in the defeat. Maybe especially in the defeat. That's the fire where resolve is formed. These last 4 years, you sailed close to the wind. You gave everything you had. You showed up for your teammates. You left it on the rink or the field or the court. That's good. At least it's good practice. Because your next stage, your next arena, you already know what I'm gonna say. It's even bigger, the stakes even higher. There are gonna be days when you feel like a wreck and you have to put on your heels and get your hair right and get it together anyway. That's okay. Because as a Heron, you trained hard so you could bring your game face on game day. There are going to be days when that teenager with whom you've been painstakingly developing rapport for the last 6 months is mad as hell, and you're the target. And the only thing you can do is be there and be present and show them you won't be scared away, that you're not going anywhere. That's okay, because as a Heron, you developed patience and stamina. You can wait for your moment, for your in. There are going to be times when you need to find the strength to tell your patient's family the worst news a loved one can ever expect to hear. That's okay too. Because as a Heron, you learn to find and access a fortitude you didn't even know you had. Sometimes it's a 75-hour week with zero thanks. Or your big idea that saves the day but goes unrecognized. Or you went the extra mile showing exceptional initiative or creativity or kindness, and you're the only one who knows. That's okay. As a Heron, you are used to sacrificing your ego for a greater cause. You already know that great things can be accomplished as long as you aren't stressing about who gets the credit. This is what heroism looks like from here on out. And yes, you ready? You're going to trade in your jerseys for scrubs, your life jackets for lab coats, your cleats for work boots. From here on out, the game changes. The rules change, the stakes change, but you can still find ways to show up, give your best, rise and fall and rise again. From now on, your wins will be in the courtroom, not on the tennis court. In the medical field, not on the soccer field. In the boardroom, not on the boards. And from there, you can still be a champion. You can still be a hero. It's not easy, but you have the tools. You're resilient, focused, creative, smart, and strong. You are experienced. You know how to lead with conviction, pull as a team, navigate rough waters to win with grace, and lose without giving up. Finally, you're not alone. You are joining hundreds of women before you, a siege of Herons who have already taken flight. Heroes who already are using their talents to make a difference in their communities and in the world. Welcome to the team. Welcome to the big stage. Get out there. Put the hero in Heron. Congratulations, seniors and class of 2020.